Hello, my name is Georgios Papadopoulos, and I have co-authored with Fabrice Théolegh, Pascal Thubert, and Nicolas Montavou the paper named IETF Reliable and Available Wireless, RAW, Use Cases and Problem Statement. This is a position paper that presents a new working group at the IETF. This is being presented as part of the 19th International Conference on Ad-hoc Networks and Wireless, Ad-hoc Now, that takes place virtually in Bari. Today I will present you the newly approved working group at the IETF called RAW for Reliable and Available Wireless. To give some background, deterministic networking refers to the allocation of predetermined physical resources in the network, such as queues, buffers, and transmission medium for flows that are known a priori, in order to avoid the statistical effects that lead to a poor bandwidth utilization, uncontrolled jitter, and congestion loss. This requires capabilities for hop-by-hop synchronization if we are talking about multi-hop networks, time-based resource reservation, which eliminates collision loss and provides the capability to transport unicast or multicast data streams of predefined characteristics such as data rate and bounded latency. To give you some examples from our daily life, the collisions of two trains using the same rails at the same time is avoided in the real world by fully scheduled operation that repeats day after day. Then the collision of two individuals renting the same apartment at the same time is again avoided by a fully scheduled operation. I will now proceed with the RAW use cases. The RAW use cases draft has already defined a number of use cases that includes wireless segment. Different use cases do need wireless connectivity for various purposes demanding reliable and available wireless behavior. So far, we have six use cases that are already included in the draft, such as pro audio video, wireless for industrial applications, and wireless gaming. Then there are other use cases that will be considered to be included are the digital aeronautical communication and potentially smart grid. Due to time constraints, I will briefly present you the wireless for industrial applications. Industry 4.0 represents the next industrial revolution. To enable cyber-physical systems, we need also a network infrastructure able to forward critical flows, guaranteeing both ultra-reliable and bounding end-to-end latencies. The DETNET working group at the IETF has provided pioneering piece of work to standardize the communication stack so that resources can be allocated end-to-end. It relies mostly on the IEEE 802.1 time-sensitive networking TSN features, where each device on the path is able to pre-reserve a port to a specific flow. Flow has a full priority to send its packets through a physical port. This way, TSN removes the competition and thus transforms the Ethernet network into a fully deterministic infrastructure. While industrial networks are expected to integrate wireless communications in the future, the wireless transmissions are known to be time variant and lossy. In these conditions, providing ultra-high reliability and low latency is particularly challenging. I will proceed with the RAW networking in the following section. Now, RAW networking aims at providing highly available and reliable end-to-end performances in a network with heterogeneous technologies and scheduled wireless segments with variable linkalities. The wireless medium presents significant challenges to achieve deterministic properties such as low packet error rate, bounded consecutive losses, and bounded latency. RAW extends the DETNET working group concept to provide high reliability and availability for an IP network. While scheduling transmissions can guarantee the time of delivery in the wired networks, it's important in the ISM band. Co-channel interference, as well as the multipath fading, which is due to echoes of the transmissions, are unavoidable. So there is no way to guarantee the delivery of the frames. So how this can be effectively achieved in wireless? The answer is diversity, diversity, and again, diversity. It takes different mitigation techniques to avoid the different issues that affect wireless transmissions. Indeed, all possible forms of diversity should be leveraged. For example, in the spatial domain by routing over multipath, in the temporal domain by retrying transmissions or sending copies over parallel paths at distinct times, and in the frequency domain with frequency hopping within frames or channel hopping between frames. Raw working group differentiates over DetNet working group since it focuses on radio segments where there are unstable links, and it focuses on forwarding optimization rather routing. We will see this part later in the presentation. Then regarding the MANET working group, RAW does not consider mobile nodes or ad hoc networking, while it is based on centralized routing, contrary to the MANET. There are already multiple drafts in that working group. Some of the main documents related with the charter are the following: RAW architecture and framework that covers the problem statement, the new terms such as Pareo, reliability. It also represents the architecture. Next, RAW use cases draft presents the wireless use cases demanding reliable and available behavior. Next, we have the RAW technologies draft that presents a series of recent technologies that are capable of time synchronization and scheduling of transmissions. Some of the technologies that are considered in the draft are 5G, 802.11, and IEEE 802.15.4. And then we have the draft, the RAW OAM draft, that presents the requirements of the operation, administration, and maintenance OAM features recommended to construct a predictable communication infrastructure on top of a collection of wireless segments. Now, RAW defines the following terms. First, we have reliability, is the first one. It defines reliability as a measure of the probability that an item will perform its intended function for a specified interval under stated conditions. For RAW, the service that is expected is delivery within a bounded latency, and a failure is when a packet is either lost or delivered too late. The next term is the availability. So availability for RAW is a measure of the relative amount of time where a path operates in stated condition. Pareo, so this is the next terminology, is packet automatic repeat request, replication, and elimination and ordering. Pareo is a superset of DetNet's packet replication, elimination, and ordering functions, PREOF, that includes radio-specific techniques such as short-range broadcast, constructive interferences, and overhearing, which can be leveraged separately or combined to increase the reliability. Next, we have the term flapping that corresponds to a radio link with time-variant quality. Typically, the wireless connectivity drops for a short period of time. Finally, we have the terminology of a track. Track abstracts the underlying technology and represents a set of resources along the path from the source to the destination. RAW specifies strict and loose tracks depending on whether the path is fully controlled by RAW or traverses an opaque network where RAW cannot observe and control the individual hops. I will proceed with the next section, which is the RAW approach. So with DataNet, the end-to-end routing can be centralized and can reside outside the network. While in wireless, and in particular in a wireless mesh, the path to the controller is expensive to maintain, consuming both airtime and energy. Note that the radio conditions may change way faster than a centralized PCE path computation element can adopt and reprogram, in particularly when the controller is distant and connectivity is slow and limited. Therefore, Rho separates the path computation timescale at which a complex path is recomputed from the path selection timescale at which the forwarding decision is taken. Now, Rho operates at the path selection timescale. Now, the Rho problem is to decide within the redundant solutions that are proposed by the PCE, which will be used for each packet to provide a reliable and available service while minimizing the waste of resources. There is thus a desire to separate the long-term computation of the route and the short-term forwarding decision. So Rho will define, Rho working group will define the path selection engine, PSE, that performs rapid local adjustments of the forwarding tables to avoid excessive use of the resource diversity that the PCE proposes. Basically, Rho will be in charge for the forwarding plane to make the per packet decision. Rho will separate the protocols and metrics that are used at both scales. The routing can operate at the long-term statistics, such as delivery ratio over minutes to hours, but as a first approximation can ignore flapping. On the other hand, the Rho forwarding decision is made at the packet speed, and it uses information that must be pertinent at the present time for the current transmission, actually. So that's it from my side. I would like to thank you very much for your attention. And if you have questions, please feel free to send me an email. Thank you very much.